can't win. You got to get reparations. Now, how are you going to get it? Let me give you a run through of three or four things very quickly because I don't want to take up the time here. First thing you must do, I've heard it mentioned already, we gotta commit a national campaign all over this country to start publicizing the issue of reparations for black folk. Not as something nice, but as a necessity, period. That means every living soul, every organization, every court, every institution in this country must begin to start promoting reparations for black folk all over this country. That's level one. It's a massive, massive promotion of reparations for black folk. Second level, level two. What we must do at second level two now is to start having fact-finding hearings. You must have fact-finding hearings all over this country. And you're gonna have fact-finding hearings on at least two different levels. One is you're gonna go out fact-finding about what roles governments have played in the reparations, in the slavery trade against black folk and enslaving the black folk, the marginalization of black folk. And that should break down into two levels. One is to investigate all levels of domestic governments, that's city, county, federal, and state governments. And the second group would go after international. So you should have two groups of black folk in this country exploring and fact-finding on what roles government have played, one domestically and one internationally. On the left-hand side, you should be doing the same thing for the domestic side. You should be going after the private sector. You should be going after all the private corporations in the United States, what roles they played and how they benefited directly from slavery. And also, on the same side, you must go after all the international corporations and the roles they played and how they benefited. Now, the Harvest Institute right now, my think tank, we've already picked up one. We put out a press release on that. We're going after domestic role that major corporations played in the United States. We've already identified approximately 240 companies that are still in existence that profiteer directly and enrich themselves off of black folk. We're going after that. And what we have to do in our fact finding is be able to factuate, document the direct line between how blacks have been crippled all the way up to economically, politically, socially, and educationally, and tied into these major corporations or tied into levels of government. That's your level two. Level three, you must then start having a national convention in this country. And right now, I think Dorothy Tillman in Chicago has already, we talked about this. She's going to try to call one in Chicago this coming year. We must have everybody who's playing a role, like Congressman Conyers and everybody from the Congress and Cobra, everybody should be at a national convention where we all come in there to not only energize each other, but to share information, see where we are. They're trying to set that up for this coming February, someplace in the United States, possibly Chicago. That's your third level. The fourth level you should start doing is out of this conference should come strategies and plans and a specific role model. You got to have a role model, a model that every black can tie into, a model for reparations. Now, my models are a little different from everyone else's, and that's because I'm outside the box. I'm trying to pull everybody else outside if I can get them. Now, most people are going to try to follow the Jewish reparations model or the Japanese model. I'm following the Indian model. The Indians are the most appropriate model if you want to track down, do anything to get reparations of black folk. Why? Because, you see, only American Indians and black folk were spelled out in the Constitution. They're Indians on reservations and black folk. There's a direct lineage between those two groups. And if you really want to track and get reparations, the easiest and quickest way is to go find out what happened to American Indians, what benefits they got, and track it. You can come right to reparations very quickly because it'll be very difficult for the government to deny black folk the same thing they're giving the Indians. So when you hear people talking about how bad off Indians are, first thing you say, fine, if Indians that bad off, put us as black folk in the same status with the Indians. We'll take that. And I can track everything right down, or we can follow the Indian model if you want to. And you can see, and all that's already built into the law, and there's a direct lineage between American Indians and black folk that you can follow very easily and get to reparations. But we need to have a model. And in my new book, I get that model. It'll be on the stand in about another month. You get the Powernomics model that'll take you through all those steps to what they did throughout history, from the Blair Amendments and everything else. You can track it very easily, and it'd be very difficult for the United States government to deny you reparations when you only two people that have a constitutional relationship with this government is black folk and Indians. Just like Indians use natural rights and lay a claim against the land, we should use natural law and lay a claim against our labor, misappropriated labor. The next level which you must do is move to a legal step. You need to form at the fourth level, get you a legal body right now, whether it's going to be pro bono or paid. And out of our convention, we should be able to raise some funds to set up a mass legal body that be ready to start serving suits based on those facts that you're going to find at the second level. And we start finding those, then we should have people going after suits, one side suing the different levels of government, other side suing the private sector to get reparation funds for black folk. You also, if you track the Indians, you should go try to get yourself some tax-exempt land. Just like Indians can go grab any piece of land and federalize and put up a casino, you tell me you ought to do the same thing as a black person, get tax-exempt statuses. We can go on and on, but there's a lot of things we can track. Go after the Indians.
Through the history books, which has all been a lie, so therefore, if it's a lie, then what's the truth? If it's a lie, then...